Brandon, it's always nice when you get recognized with an individual award. And he was the AFC Offensive Player of the Week last week. But when you do it in a win, so much the better.
Absolutely. And he was all talking about that win, not so much the award he received on Wednesday.
It's a nice-looking award. I wonder if he took it home, then got a car, showed it off to the kids in the neighborhood, passed it around. I wonder what he did for it.
23 yards on the tuck and run. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Flush to his right. They'll try and run it. And he's got this down to the 35. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. And he's got a man wide open, complete. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
Want me to jump in on you, partner, but they didn't waste any time getting downfield, did they? I mean, nice big play there.
Three plays, three successful plays in plus territory. Now this defense on its heels a bit.
It seems like they had something targeted there, doesn't it? It's like, okay, we've got a matchup we like coming right out of the gate. Let's go ahead and get right to it.
All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
But there was pressure all around him, so the only...
And he is in! Touchdown! touchdown run. And the Raiders drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Well, these guys scored touchdown after touchdown in that win a week ago. So how do they come out this week? Same way. They've got that momentum going, a touchdown on the opening drive.
I think it's safe to say that they're in a groove, isn't it? I mean, a lot of times we've seen where teams have scored a ton of points the week before. The very next week struggle to score almost as if they used it all up. Not in this case. This group appears locked in.
We're going to have to make some adjustments if you're on the other side of that football. Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this carries into the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. So here's the Charger offense making their way out. And a look here at their go-to guy under center.
And this is a game. For grit, determination, and somehow finding a way not to panic. What a horrible start for them. I mean, they haven't won a game yet. So now, as a quarterback, you're not just talking to your team. You got to demonstrate to them what they need to do to win. He's got to be the leader by how he plays.
He'll lose it. Second and 11.
Behind the line of scrimmage.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
Second and 11 at the 24-yard line.
Now a give, right side, Davison. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 14 on that one and a first down. They had three tight ends in on that set, and they were really good at blocking for their running back.
And give them a lot of credit because in football nowadays, tight ends coming out of college often don't block very often. These guys have really developed into superior blockers, and that's why they use them in this formation so often.
6-yard pickup brings up second and four at the 44-yard line.
On second down, Davison. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. They'll set up a throw. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
They were swarming that time and ultimately got to him before he could get rid of the football and knocked it free.
And don't you feel just a little bit of sympathy for him back there, though? So much going on, so much swirling around. He's trying to find someone downfield. He's trying to move around to find an open target. Sometimes you forget the number one thing, take care of the football.
Following the fumble recovery, Harrison is going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
Second and 10.
to throw again. Harrison, he's going to try and go deep again. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So the contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got back.
It's their quarterback with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. Not a bad start for him. Two drives for the offense, two rushing TDs.
Almost like he's in the percussion section in the band, isn't it? Got a little oomph, right? Got a little crash, got a little bang. He's got it all as he gets to the end zone. Second rushing touchdown, as you noted, on two drives. He's off to a terrific start.
Okay, you ready? Wait for it.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Chargers get set to go here for their second drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
You always hear about empty possessions. Some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you. And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
And he is going to have the Chargers first down by a couple of yards as they're able to get four there on third and two. And they pick up the first down there with a gain of four.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Right back to him on first down. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now, I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football. Let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game. They're giving him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Rose.
The pass.
And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they get five there on third and two.
First down, Chargers.
Back to throw now on first down. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And a loose football. And the Raiders pick it up.
Come on, get it.
And he's into the end zone. It's a fumble return for six and a Raider touchdown. Took off. There was no catching.
And I know every team tells you to hustle no matter what the play, but there was no chance of catching him. Maybe if it had been a defensive tackle running with the ball, but not in this case.
I was just about to say he had missed an extra point all season, but there it is. His first miss, no good.
Turn it up, carry system, incredible, 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 incredible,
has the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles.
And in just about every game we see, partner, what do? When we look at the stat sheet, we go right to
the turnover differential.
Without it. The game, and I know there's still plenty of time to go, but you got to take care of the football in order to win it.
They'll run on first down. Davison, and he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
And the Chargers first down.
The gun, they'll look to throw. It's a short. Here, complete to the tight end. A gain of 6 there on first.
We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it. Occasionally, you break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. But also, if they they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers. Now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And that's a nice catch there. Remember, he had the fumble earlier. No way he was giving up the ball in that situation. Secured it tight to his body and picks up the first down.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 36. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had two interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding what receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
Number 33, the ball.
The numbers for him from a week ago, 19 carries, 117 yards, and a touchdown.
And he's been a touchdown machine for this season. He's number one in the league in rushing touchdowns. So that has to help the entire offense as a whole. Play action passes, other people have a chance to touch the football because if you're a defense, you absolutely have to key on him.
It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. Now a give, right side, Carlisle. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. And he'll give it here to his running back. And they'll get this down to the 10. They scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Here's 2nd and goal, operating from the 8-yard line. They run the counter. Carlisle. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long 3rd and goal. Now a handoff here to his running back. He's going to be very close to a 1st down. Good running, but looks like he's a yard short. It'll be a gain of 5, but they do keep him. And he's over the line and in for a Raider touchdown. A great effort there. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Raiders add on to their lead.
Well, partner, time to start thinking about dinner plans after this one. I don't want to write them off first quarter, but my goodness, the offense clicking like this and a 4-score lead.
We are programmed to not get to that stage, right? To not think that way, but you can't help it. They look like sheer perfection right now with those 4 scores this early. Let's see if they can keep it up, and let's see if there's any way possible they can be slowed down.
Yeah, right now, I don't see any signs of them being slowed down.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
The Charger drive about to get going. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Oh, he can't hang on. That was a dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick. But instead, it falls down incomplete.
At the 21-yard line.
Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead. The last catch did get 3, but they're still left needing 7 yards on 3rd down. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he is going to have the Chargers' 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. 2nd catch for him today, and it'll wind up a 1st down. And the Raiders pick it up, and they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 40.
42-yard line.
Defense.
Now here's an inside give. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run.
He's brought down at the 42-yard line.
On second down now, Carlisle, and he'll be close to a first down at the Chargers 34.
He's tackled at the 34-yard line.
On third down, Carlisle, and he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. First down, Carlisle. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Give them 12 yards that time, and a Las Vegas first. They'll run on first down, Carlisle. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. And he's able to get it down at a 2-yard line. They give him further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
A loss of 2 on the play. It's third.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. No gain on the play that time, so a big stop, and it's going to leave him with a fourth and goal.
At the line of scrimmage.
On fourth down, Harrison, the quick slant caught. And he... in. Touchdown, Raiders. A 5-yard touchdown. And the Raiders are pouring it on.
There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
And the route is on here in this first half. A 10-play drive that time. And it winds up in 6 points for the Raiders. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this carries into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
That's our own 25-yard.
Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again.
He was off to a very hot start here in this first quarter, but did have the fumble last drive. Now we'll see if the psyche kicks in here and which side it kicks in on.
And I know we're going to focus on him because he's having a good half, just dropped the ball, and he's having a really nice game. But I'm going to take the defense's perspective here. They're thinking now, he's dropped one. Let's attack him and see if he'll do it again.
And that's going to be good for a Chargers first down as the tackle made at the line.
It's a gain of 10.
And the ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
Charger football to start quarter number 2 as they've got a 2nd and 8 forthcoming. Charger football to start quarter number 2 as they've got a 2nd and 8 forthcoming. Now left side on the swing pass. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
To number 38.
The Chargers on 3rd down. A perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. Here it's 3rd and 2. And again, this time the tailback. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
Another down on the scoreboard, but the urge to go for it is almost irresistible here on fourth and short. Yeah, I know they're on their own side of the field.
I was going to say.
Normally, I would say punt the ball away, but I'm feeling it. I say go for it.
A nice return that time of about 14 yards. And possession will switch hands first onto the field. He's in his own second quarter, already closing in on a 100-yard game.
And that's the magic number for a running back. Anytime you get to that triple digits, that's all you're looking for. But he's got a chance to really exceed that in this one.
Yeah, he does. That's been the gold standard for a long time, hasn't it, that 100-yard mark?
It really had. And that never has to shift because it's in a game. It's a 1,000-yard mark. I'm wondering, since we've gone from 12 to 14 to 16 games, maybe we need to up.
That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball in the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of game. Operating from the gun, Harrison flushed out right, still running, and he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
Harrison's pass.
They'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down.
A gain of nine brings up third and two.
From the gun, Harrison escaping the pressure right. And it's going to be caught for a Raider touchdown. A 24-yard touchdown. And this offense is running away with this one.
Okay, we need to double check here with Marvin because he keeps all of our good stats, but what I've got is